Good morning, gang. It's Friday the 17th of March 2017. It is St. Patrick's Day, boys and girls, so we must sing together the hymn from the great St. Patrick's Day. Here we go, gang. Hail glorious Saint Patrick, dear saint of Aral, on us thy poor children bestow a sweet smile. And now thou art high in the mansions above, on Erin's green valley look down in thy love, on Erin's green valley, on Erin's green valley, on Erin's green valley, look down in thy love. There we are for all our millions. I'm sure there are millions this morning, boys and girls, millions of Irish people all over the world joining us today for our little St. Patrick's Day show, which is just like a normal show, really, but with a little hymn at the beginning there for you. And as indicated up there, the Irish flag stands proudly above our very own Union flag for you this morning. A happy St. Patrick's Day and top of the morning to you all today. Wow. How fabulous is that? Just a little bit of history on St. Patrick's Day, occurring annually. This is one of those events that comes on the same date every year. A bit like Christmas Day, Boxing Day. Same date always, 17th of March. Unlike other events during the year, Easter can be, it can be 2 or 3 weeks, different date and like that. St. Patrick's Day, always on the 17th of March. It will be mad today. It will be mad tonight in the pubs and bars, certainly across London. I'm sure it's the same everywhere else. But I think probably it's the biggest party day, even almost on the same lines as New Year's Eve, which can be very hit and miss nowadays. That was always ruined, unfortunately, when we went from 1999 to 2000 and all the clubs started getting very, very greedy with their door entry and that sort of thing, and it just killed it. And ever since then, it's never recovered. You can't guarantee a good New Year's Eve, but generally, you can guarantee a good St. Patrick's night, and the Guinness will be flowing tonight. Not my cup of tea, really. Mind you, no alcohol is my cup of tea, to be honest. No, we like tea. Tea only. But the Guinness will be flowing tonight. St. Patrick's Day occurring annually on the March the 17th in observance of the death of St. Patrick, the patron saint of Ireland. What began as a religious feast day in the 17th century has evolved into a variety of festivals across the globe celebrating Irish culture with parades, special foods, music, dancing and a whole lot of green. As you can see, I am in green this morning, boys and girls. My mate Ron is in New York at the moment with his other half Andy and quite a lot of his family as well. And they have specifically gone for the very, very famous St. Patrick's Day parade, which happens in New York. And indeed, there's a cathedral in New York, St. Patrick's Cathedral, where I've been a couple of times over the years. And that's one beautiful place. The last time I went, was for the Barry Manilow concert a couple of years ago. And I not in the cathedral, but I wanted to go into the cathedral and it was all being done up and it was there's a bit of dust in it. It was all surrounded by scaffolding and all that. So it must look particularly nice there. I must go again sometime. Let's say hello to the early people today. Good morning to Mark. Morning, Mark C. Mark C, Rod Brown there. Might just try to sing. Well, I hope you were singing along to that. It was hymn number 93 in your parish hymn books. Yes, indeed, Rod. Morning to Mary Moore. Juan, it's non-Irish Mary from Ireland who's with us this morning as well. Morning, Mary. I hope you were singing along to that as well. Wendy's there. Good morning, Wendy. She's a little bit busy today and wishes us all a happy St. Patrick's Day as well. Mark says he might Skype in this morning. Oh, we are honoured this morning, Mark.
Feel free to Skype in if you want to. Mary says her brother was actually ordained. She's got a priest as a brother, and he was actually ordained at St. Patrick's Cathedral. So there's something we I didn't know that. Good morning, Mary. Lily's with us this morning as well. Mary says, we Irish are consistent. Yes, every year, 17th of March. Get those Guinnesses down, you. Mary's also impressed with the flag, of course. There is. I can't lie to you, Mary. The flag isn't really there. Those two flags, Mary, I don't know if you know, they're not really there. Look. Right? They are projected onto the screen by electronics. But it doesn't matter, does it? They actually look better when they're done as they are now, rather than a proper flag on the wall there. Lily's coming along to the karaoke today. Excellent, 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 excellent. Adam's with us this morning as well. So there we are. Perhaps you've got some experiences of St. Patrick's Day you want to share with me this morning. Then I'd love to hear them. Phone lines are open instantly this morning. There it is. 020-8144-3477 is my phone number this morning. Okay. 020-8144-3477. If you have a Skype, if you've got Skype, you can Skype in as well. My Skype in number is all one word, United Kingdom Talk. Okay, Skype in name, United Kingdom Talk. Or use our local London phone number. I know I always say that, but you never know who's listening. And there might be someone, oh, I don't want to ring that. That's a premium rate number. No, it's not. No, it's not. It's a normal local London number. And if you want to call in this morning and tell me your experiences, perhaps, of St. Patrick's Day over the... Especially Mary. I'd love someone Irish to call in this morning. Mary, if you're still there, then please feel free to call in and tell us all about St. Patrick's Nights over the years that you've experienced, gone to, the successful ones, perhaps the non-successful ones. Did great fights break out? I doubt that very much. Not as a St. Patrick's Night. People might be slung out for being too drunk, but certainly not fighting. Then call in and let us know this morning. 020-8144-3477. The number's up there in the left-hand corner of the screen, just in between our wonderful Irish flag and the Union flag directly underneath it. 020-8144-3477 is our phone number. Generally, nowadays for myself, we will, of course, have St. Patrick's Night at Central Station tonight. It's Friday night, so I'll be hosting karaoke tonight at Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross, if you'd like to join us down there. It will be a busy night. I must warn you, it will be a busy night. Certain regular people have cottoned on to how busy these nights are and are getting there earlier and earlier. In fact, last week, I think it was Maureen last week, she was actually there before me. Roy and Lawrence, regular karaoke people. Lawrence doesn't sing, Roy does. But they always get there early as well. So it's a good idea to get there early. If you're coming tonight, especially, it's Central Station, Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. I'll be hosting karaoke there from 8:30 until midnight. I would get there about 8 o'clock just to get yourself a table. You don't want to be standing. I mean, there's plenty of room to stand up. There is room to stand up. But, you know, when you're watching a karaoke, it's nice to be able to sit down for a while, isn't it? Don't you think? So good idea to get there around about 8 o'clock tonight, I would say, anyway. All right, and as requested, I'm very lucky to tell you that Mary has just joined us on the phone in Chalk Farm. Good morning, Mary, in London.
Good morning.
Good morning, all right. Could you just turn me off?
Top of the morning to you.
Could you just turn me off on your gadgets, whatever you're listening on?
Yeah.
Thanks, darling. Otherwise, it all echoes back.
I can turn you off anytime.
Yeah, I think you can actually, especially when you shove that dress over me when we're doing our little little act. And a top of the morning to you, Mary.
Top of the morning to you, love. Happy St. Patrick's Day, love. Féile Pádraig, as we say. So even though you say I'm not Irish, but you know I am, really.
Well, that's what you said to me.
Just that I found that the ancestors were born in Marylebone.
They were born where?
In Marylebone.
In Marlon?
Marylebone.
Marylebone. Oh, okay. Yeah. Marylebone, yes. Where BBC Radio London is.
Yeah.
Are you pleased with my efforts this morning?
Oh, what a day. sun is nearly out.
The sun has got its hat on. Hip, 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 hooray! Yes, if you only...
Yes, I will be going to Central later. I've made this fantastic vodka jelly cake.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it's the tricolour one. You know, the green, white and the orange.
Oh, that sounds nice. Is it a cake?
But you don't drink, so
Is it a cake or jelly?
It's jelly.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, you make sure you tell people there's stuff in it. Otherwise, they might get drunk and then drive home and then crash and it'll be your fault.
You know, you don't want Roy to be going mad completely.
No, no. Well, I don't know so much. I mean, it's quite nice when people go mad like us, to be honest.
Exactly. So I presume you have a good range of Irish music there.
It's the same stuff as what's always in there. There's Only Ireland over here. McNamara's band is in there. There's all sorts of stuff in there. Yeah, yeah. You know how to look up my my songbook online, do you?
Oh, no, I don't know how to do that.
Oh, it's very easy. I'll send you a little link.
Okay.
All right, yes.
And I can practice all day.
Of course, of course.
As I always
do. What are you going to sing for us tonight?
Fields of Ath and Rye.
Yeah.
Do you have Whiskey in the Jar? And do you have The Wild Rover?
Yes, got all of those.
Okay.
I'm going to do McNamara's band. My name is McNamara, I'm the leader, of the band. That's the one.
Blah, blah, blah.
What?
A bit of Dana.
A bit of Dana, yeah.
Oh,
I don't know if I want to do that one now instead. Well, what I'll do is see what other people are doing and then I'll do something else because I always like to put the singers first, you know that.
Well, I'll be down early. I've made a massive Irish stew and 3 out of 5 people who are coming for lunch have cancelled.
Oh, what time is the lunch then?
Not vegetarian.
What time is the lunch?
2 o'clock,
yeah. I wouldn't be able to park or anything.
And you wouldn't be able to eat it.
No,
because
it's got dead animals in it. I don't eat dead animals, Mary.
I
keep telling you, top of the morning to you now, dear.
I've been on the phone to Australia this morning.
Oh, lovely, to the family.
So nice. And America's coming up later, and then Argentina. But,
you got family all over the world, haven't you, Mary?
Everywhere except here.
All over. I'm your family here. The Central Station people are your family. That's what it is.
They are. And our Kira's coming home.
Oh, lovely.
Today for Easter holiday.
That's your daughter, yeah.
It's a bit early, a bit quick. But sure,
that is a long holiday. Anyway. Are they split up for Easter? Actually, I think one of my cousin's daughter or son has broken up university for Easter. Is that right?
That's what Kira's doing.
Well, how long do they get holiday then?
I think it's about 6 weeks.
Well, we only used to get that in the summer.
But, like, Kira's soon, she's about to do her finals next term.
Yes.
So, she needs 6 weeks at home with her mammy.
Well, that's a long time to be on holiday. Can you tell me your most memorable St. Patrick's night out, Mary?
My most memorable St. Patrick's night was in a pub in Camden that used to be called Tommy Flynn's.
Oh, I've heard of that, yes.
Yeah, and I did it for about 4 years. I made the Irish stew and the bacon and cabbage.
And the what?
And 1 year I served 200 people.
What was that cabbage you said? Something about a cabbage?
Bacon and cabbage.
Bacon cabbage?
Bacon.
Oh, bacon and cabbage, yes.
Yeah,
so dead animal and cabbage, yes.
And I served 200 people.
Wow.
And I felt really brilliant about it. There was some chef came in and the manager came over to me and he said, oh, he wants another portion.
Oh.
And then your man said afterwards, tell your chef that's the best bacon and cabbage I've ever had. It was better than my mother's. So I served like 200 people.
What, with one cabbage?
No.
What did you do? Oh, I know what you did. You're Catholic, aren't you? So you must have blessed the cabbage before you started and got another 200 out of the one, like they do with a fish. The fish and the bread.
I mean, we started at midday.
Yes.
And by about 8 o'clock, I was free. But I had been behind the jump, you know, so I felt safe there. You know, because all these plastic patties come out of the woodwork.
Oh, ooh, yeah, plastic. Irish, that's a good one. Plastic patties. I love it. The people that are alone, they're only Irish on the one day of the only Irish on the one day of the year. Then are they?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
But I remember I finished. I'd been working. Obviously, it took me at least a day's prep to do all the food. So I finished work about 8 o'clock, and I went around the other side of the jump, and oh my God, I felt, yeah. I mean, just people were so drunk, so awful. Then, for some reason, the manager decided to let the security go at about 10 o'clock.
Oh, what?
Yeah.
To save money, yep, to save money.
So
yep.
I'm standing by the security door, just having a glass of wine, talking to a couple of people. And then one of my neighbours from where I used to live, he was in there and he opened the side door and a few thug type people came in and I managed to throw them out.
You did?
Yes.
Well, of course, you protected my karaoke night once, didn't you?
Yeah.
Not that we were being attacked. We weren't being attacked. They were just falling all over the place. I remember you standing in front of the equipment. That would be in the Spread Eagle in Camden with your arms out like that, protecting me, dear. Protecting me against evilness. Yeah.
Your equipment is so precious.
It is precious. It is precious. No equipment, no singing. How bad can it get?
Well, it could get worse.
Well, I don't know. So you managed to sling them out of the pub, did you? Well done, Mary.
Yeah,
I think you could get a job as a door lady.
You know, the manager saw me just like, get out of my pub.
Get out of my pub.
Get out of my pub. But these were people, you know, who lived across the road from me. I just said, get out of my pub. Slammed the door. But I've never seen a bar manager jump across the jump ever. It was like Cheltenham.
Was it like a horse? Was it like a horse race in there?
But you can imagine the scene. You know me in my frock.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm standing there in a silvery, greeny, sparkly number.
I'm sure you'll have a green number on tonight, won't you?
Well, actually, I've just been going through the wardrobe.
Oh, it's such a which wardrobe, you know. Those who don't Mary, know Mary, she has a large mansion in Chalk Farm, boys and girls. Her wardrobe, well, when she says wardrobe, she means room. She's got an entire room full of little costumes and little bits and pieces. You've got anything from a you know, £500,000 ball gown to a very small, skimpy bikini that she sometimes wears on the beach in various poses.
Because I pay for my frock.
Because Mary, of course, she used to have an annual calendar coming out every year with various poses sitting there, you know, in the grid. And all of them are green. All the bikinis she's got are green, aren't they, Mary?
Yes, dear. If you say so, dear. That reminds me, maybe I should bring the horse's head tonight and say I've come back from Cheltenham.
Bring the horse's head. Bring the horse's head. She's got this rubber horse's head that she puts on. Tell me, is there much of a difference between the St. Patrick's nights in different parts of the world? So starting off with Ireland.
Yeah, it's good. But, I mean, the parades there are, you know, very much in the, you know, our local town. Dublin does a big parade, but half the crowd would be American tourists who come over for it. And you get all the American marching bands, you know, the young ones throwing the things up in the air. What do you call them? Cheerleaders.
Oh, those stick things. I don't know what they're called.
Stick things.
Stick cheerleader sticks. I don't know what they're called. Yeah.
And Boston, of course, they've dyed the river green.
Yes.
Because Boston is probably 50% Irish.
Right, okay, I didn't know that. Yep, right.
I have not been to the parade in London.
Do they have a parade in London?
Yes, mega.
I wonder where does that happen? Hang on, Irish.
I've gone to Trafalgar Square.
Right, let's have a look at that.
A few years ago, my son went down there with his dad.
Yeah.
And because his uncle, blah, 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 somebody, a politician, was over. Anyway, my son gets to go backstage, kind of thing. And he met Michael Flatley.
Yeah.
You know, the river dancer.
Yes. I think you should perform a river dance on the stage tonight, Mary. Stop we it. Should try that.
Right, I'll practice.
We should try that tonight.
Yeah. We also met the Irish ambassador, Dan Mulhall. I think that's his name.
I've got the information here, Mary. It doesn't say a time.
Well, it starts, I think, about 12 on Sunday. But there's also an Irish festival in Camden Market tomorrow.
Yeah, I've got it here in front of me. Starts Friday the 17th. It says, cheer on the St. Patrick's Parade and join in the celebrations in Trafalgar Square. But there's no time there. Yeah, well, that's on the mayor's website.
The big parade will be on Sunday. But Camden...
Yeah, but what time?
Camden Lock Market, they have a festival tomorrow with loads of Irish up-and-coming talent playing there. So that I'm going to pop down to that because it's a 3 minutes walk.
It's got a Watch Irish Cinema with Film London. But there's no addresses or time. And this is on the mayor's... That's Sadiq, dear. He don't know what he's doing half the time,
exactly,
bless his heart.
Exactly.
It's all very well listing the stuff, but how do you know what times to get to these places? How stupid. Hang on, let's try visitlondon.com. They might have something. It tells you, here we go, look, St. Patrick's Day Parade, be amazed by flamboyant pageantry, elaborate floats, marching bands, and it goes on. It tells you where it is, but not time to be, what time to be there, how stupid is that?
Well, if you're Irish, you'll know what time to be sure.
What is it the same time always then? Is it? I don't know what time it is.
I can't remember.
Oh, well, that's silly, that is, isn't it?
But also, I don't do huge crowds.
No?
You get down there and there's all these plastic paddies.
Yeah.
Like I said.
Yeah, yeah.
Pushing and milling around and then you have to get all the way back to Camden.
Oh, dear. Such a long way to go for your films and whatever. Do you know what... Here, I just got a little noise on my mobile phone. You know I've got a new gadget.
I've heard that.
I've got a new gadget, and it's a video answer phone, and I just heard my phone vibrate. You can't hear it because I turn it off when I'm doing this worldwide phenomenon known as United Kingdom Talk with an Irish flavour this morning. Uh-huh. And it flashed up, and it was my postman delivering my postlady delivering my letters. How fantastic is that? You can't come near my front door anymore without being detected. Detected. I've given the link to it to my best mate, so he can see. No, I did think of giving the link so they could watch on the camera as well. You see, they could just log in and see it any time. I did think of giving it to my neighbour and my sister, but how can I put this? The trouble is, perhaps I don't want certain people to be seen coming to my door. You know what I'm saying, Mary? Do you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah,
he's got another visitor today. Luck should be a fine thing, dear.
So, you know, I'm coming to Central tonight.
Good.
But having worked in various pubs in Camden on St. Patrick's Day for many, many years, I might actually bypass Camden because last St. Patrick's Day, I went out at about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. I got to a pub I used to work in, and before I could even get a drink, I was kissed by about 8 blokes.
Oh.
Yeah.
So just before you carry on there, Mary, what's the name of that pub? I might pop in there myself.
No, I'm not telling you.
Oh, please.
No, it's a well-known.
If I go in there when the lads are a little bit more tanked up, I might get a bit of luck, might I? What if I go dressed up as a woman? Would that help, do you think?
It might do. it's like testosterone.
What sort of things would you recommend for St. Patrick's Night? Green fishnet stockings and a little green pixie hat, perhaps?
I don't have any. Anyway, my love, I better get on with the day because I've got to make up the room for our Kira coming home from college.
All right.
I will see you later. I go down early. And I hope that you let me sing at least two songs.
At least two songs tonight, Mary. Get there nice and early and we'll get two in at least.
Two in at least.
And Ray Reynolds is making an unusual Friday appearance tonight just to come and see you on St. Patrick's night, I'm sure.
Oh, bless him. I love Ray Reynolds.
I want
to adopt him.
Well, I hope your stew goes very well this afternoon, all right?
All right, Dave. I'll catch you later.
Bye-bye, Mary.
Take care, love. Bye.
Bye now. There's non-Irish Mary from Ireland calling in this morning. Have you got a memory of St. Patrick's night? If you've got one, call in and tell me about it this morning. Good or bad, doesn't matter. You know, whatever happened. Maybe you got a bit drunk and ended up in a bus in Southend or somewhere horrendous like that. Then let us know. 020 8144 3477 is my phone number this morning. We've got another call coming in here from it's a mobile. Good morning. Who's that, please?
Hi, it's Karim.
Karim? Hello, Karim. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Great to hear you, sir. Karim used to come along to Belushi's in Hammersmith, where I used to DJ on Saturday nights. I don't think you ever came. Did you come to the karaoke? I can't remember now.
Yeah, we did.
You did a couple of times come to the karaoke. Did you sing? Did you sing?
No, I didn't. I was coming with the birds.
You were there for the ladies?
Yeah.
Well, they were all floating around you. You didn't have much trouble getting hold of them, did you?
No, I didn't.
Was it the suave? It's the tan, suave, sophisticated look. That's what it was, Karim. There you were, marching in, you know, head held high. All your mates sitting around the side. Nothing for them, all for you.
How you doing?
I'm really well, thank you very much. I still miss that place. Do you know it's been, it's got to be 6 or 7 years now.
Yeah, it's changed.
It goes so...
They've got new staff now. Completely changed.
All new staff, have they?
Yeah, Spencer's not there anymore.
Oh, yeah. See, he went some time ago. He was the doorman, wasn't he? He was a nice bloke. Where is he now?
No, Spencer. Spencer was the manager.
Spencer? I don't know a Spencer.
Yeah,
I went through Robbie... Then there was Chris, and then there was Vicky. Vicky was with me there the longest. And then from Vicky, it went to Dustin. And Dustin's the one that changed it all in there.
Yeah, no, it completely changed. New management, new staff, everything.
Is it good?
Yeah, it's better now. It's packed, always packed on Thursday, Friday, Saturday. It's always packed.
Excellent. Because I think at one point, Karim, it went a bit posh, didn't it? Or they tried to make it a bit posh, do you think?
Yeah, they did, yeah.
And what have they done now? Have they gone back to their roots, so to speak, and everyone's welcome sort of thing, or what?
Yeah, everyone's welcome. They've got a new dormer and everything.
Oh, lovely. So you spend your Saturday nights in there much?
Yeah, now and again.
Now, you did promoting, didn't you? You promoted somewhere for a while.
Yeah, no, I still do it.
Oh, you're still doing that job, are you?
Yeah, still doing it.
Have you got a special night on tonight for St. Patrick's?
No, I'm not doing it. I'm out tonight. I'm going to O'Neill's.
Oh, O'Neill's. That'd be a bit of a celebration in there, wouldn't it? Yeah, yeah. Absolutely. Not far, is it? Where is that one?
That's Piccadilly.
Oh, you've got to go all the way up there. Still looking for the ladies up there, are you? Haven't you settled down yet, Karim?
No, not yet.
How old are you now?
29 this month.
I think it might be time for you to get married, my friend.
I know. When the right one comes along.
Oh, that'd be lovely, wouldn't it? I'm actually looking for a karaoke or quiz night sort of during the week if you're here of one going.
Yeah, what, during the week? Oh, you are doing it.
Huh? I do a couple now, but there's no. I'm not really doing any straight venues at the moment for karaoke. I would like to do one.
It would be a good idea.
Yeah, I'd like to do a Belushi's again or something like that. Maybe on a Tuesday, Wednesday, or on a Tuesday or a.
Why don't you do that some nights in Hammersmith?
Eh?
Why don't you do some nights in Hammersmith?
In Hammersmith, well, nothing's come up. The last place I did in Hammersmith, and I think it's changed its name now. It was next to is it Chinese or Japanese? Is there a Wagamama now there?
Yeah, Wagamama, yeah.
Yeah, there was a pub next to it. I think it's called the Draft House now, is it?
Oh, yeah. I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, I did a Saturday night karaoke in there for a while. But, sometimes it was okay, but generally it didn't really work in there. We didn't get many people in for it.
It worked in Belushi a lot.
Pardon?
I say it works in Belushi a lot.
Yeah, well, I used to. They don't have it in there, though, anymore, do they? I don't think they have it in the Shepherd's Bush. Because the DJ and Karim, I gave most of that up now. I only do sort of two. I mean, you couldn't really class them as DJ nights. I play the music and put a I don't do the show. I put a show on, you know, work the sound and lights, and I do a little bit of comparing. You'd call it MCing.
Do a strip show?
Eh?
Whether you did a strip show.
No, I haven't got the body for it. You're welcome to come and do a strip show in front of me, Karim. Oh, it's lovely to hear you. You have a lovely St. Patrick's night tonight. All right, mate.
Take care.
Really good to hear from you. Thanks for calling in. Bye-bye, Karim. There, he's a lovely bloke, he is. He used to come along to the Belushi's, as I say. Hang on. In Hammersmith, and always had time for him to come and talk to me, and then he'd be off chatting up all the ladies and all that. Wonderful. 020-8144-3477 is the phone-in number today. Tell me about your St. Patrick's nights. Good ones, bad ones, or maybe you just want to tell me, maybe you're going somewhere tonight and you want to tell us about it, perhaps sort of advertise the night. Then call in and tell us. 020-8144-3477 is my local London number. Or you can Skype in on United Kingdom Talk, all right? Here comes some of your messages coming into the show this morning. He says, pushing a button there. Mark's going to call in shortly. Hurry up, Mark. We're waiting for your call. Good morning to our good friend Colin. Colin, I hope you're doing okay. I think you're a little bit not too well a little while ago, and it's been going on a bit. Colin, the trouble is, I've certainly noticed, as I went over 45 years old, I noticed illnesses and aches and pains, they hang around forever, don't they? They absolutely hang around forever. I've had a few different things, actually. I had really painful feet, which went on for nearly 2 years. Mark's calling in now. There we go. Good morning, Mark. How are you today? Hello, Mark.
Good morning.
I've got you. Hello, Mark. All right.
You can hear me. Yeah, okay. How are you?
Where are you? Are you Hackney? I can't remember now.
No, I'm in Edgware.
In Edgware in London. Good morning, Mark. And Mark works for Arsenal Football Club. You do the, what's it called? What is the title of your job? Oh, have we lost you? Hello, Mark? Mark? I think we've lost him. Because your call counter's still going round there, so I don't know why I can't hear you. Maybe you want to try calling again. Yeah. There we go. That was strange. Could not hear any sound. There we go. Let's send feedback. You might call in again in a moment. Yeah, the call got dropped. I don't know why that call got dropped then, Mark. Do you want to give us another ring? What was I just about talking about then? Can't remember. Oh, signal issues. Okay, can you move to another room or something and try again? I'll wait for you to call in again. Okay, 020-8144-3477. Yeah, I was just saying to Colin there, I had terribly bad feet for about 2 years, and it was the tendons either side. Would you like to see? 1 minute here. Look, here we are. So that's my foot here, right? That side there, and the same on the other foot. They became inflamed, and we don't really know why. I changed my shoes and all sorts of things. I went to the doctor. He sent me to a foot specialist. Is that a chiropractor? Something like that. I went to a private one. They gave me these things to put in my shoes, but nothing was working. I went to a place and I had some sort of ultrasound treatment on the side of my foot. Nothing worked. Nothing worked. And then it was just after Christmas. This is a couple of years ago. It was just after Christmas. And suddenly they just started working. Suddenly, the pain just disappeared, and fortunately, they've been all right ever since. So that's my feet. I've had tummy troubles, as you well know, for a year and a half. But recently, I was given some antibiotics for the doctor for something completely different for my throat and ears, because they kept getting really itchy, and he thought there might be an infection. So I had this penicillin. And after that, it was difficult to control. It was difficult to control having to run to the toilet while on the penicillin. Well, that finished a couple of weeks ago, and guess what? The tummy problems appear to have cleared up. I had constipation. I couldn't go. And this went on for a year and a half. And I'm hoping that whatever the penicillin seems to have done something, in that it cleared something out, and I haven't had a problem since. So I've got fingers crossed there. So I know, Colin, you have. As you get older, things take so long to sort themselves out. What was the other thing I had? Oh, yes, what I thought was a lump in my throat. I had a camera up the nose, not a nice experience. I had ultrasound on there and all this business, and they couldn't find what it was. And until another doctor says, I think you've got a bit of acid coming up while you're asleep in bed, you know, reflux. He said, try Galveston Advance. He said, have some of that before you go to bed at night, see what happens. And I did. It cleared up. So these illnesses, as you get older, just get longer and longer and longer to try and get rid of, don't they? Thank you, Colin. Mark says the St. Patrick's Day parade in London is between 12 midday and 6 o'clock tonight. So if you're not doing anything this afternoon, I'm sure Mark will be going to that. He loves to go to all these events and what have you. Then that's well worth going to see, the Irish parade. Although the best one, I gather, is, apart from in Ireland, of course, I gather the best one is in New York, and my mate is there at the moment. Is it 4 or 5 hours behind us in New York? So he won't be up yet. 11, 10, 9, 8, 7. I think it's about 6 or 7 o'clock in the morning there at the moment. So he won't be up yet. But he's going to that today. He's over in New York. Oh, it's cold over there at the moment. It was -5 there last night. Sod that. It's so cold in New York. Do not go to New York in the winter. I'm telling you now. It's dreadful. And in the summer, it goes too far the other way. It's so hot. Real extremes temperatures in New York. We don't really get that here so much. Hello to Shania, who says, we'll have to catch up when I finish. Hello, Shania. Good morning to you, darling. Ashley, it says, I'm secretly watching you at work while I've pulled up on delivery. Do be careful, Ashley. Good morning, lovely Ashley. How are you today? Are you coming to sort of St. Patrick's Day tonight? Or Mary, if you're still listening, can you bring your Irish flags? I mean, they may well do the bar up anyway in Australia, in Australia, in Irish. Oh, I'm thinking of your family. You've got family in Australia, haven't you? They may well do flags up anyway, but bring your little Irish flags if you've got them as well. Or maybe you've got a big one as well, or a couple, and we can drape them over the, there's a long bench behind on the stage, isn't there? Good morning to Tweety Charlotte, who sends us what are they called now? The little Irish plant. Oh, it's gone right out of my head. Clover leaves. Are they Irish? Just a minute. Irish plant. What is it called now? I can't remember what it's called now. Irish Garden Society. Oh, plant list. Wildflowers of Ireland. Is it here? Oh, there's hundreds of them. Four leaf. Is it a clover? The Irish. The shamrock. You stupid man, Chris. Shamrock, yes. Just bring shamrocks in as well this evening. Where would you get a shamrock from? Can you grow those here? I suppose you can. We've got the same sort of weather as you have in Ireland, haven't you? So bring those along today as well. Ashley said, what time will you be on tonight? Won't get to the pub till about 10-ish. I start at 8:30 tonight, Ashley. That's at Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. 8:30 is showtime tonight. I actually get there around about 7:45 because I like to be all set up and ready. So that's karaoke tonight, Central Station, Wharfdale Road, King's Cross, every Friday from 8:30. It'll be extra busy tonight, I guarantee you, because of the Irish celebrations, all right? Yes, Mary's going to bring her bunting along, her little Irish flags as well. So that's excellent. Tanya's with us this morning. Good morning, Tanya. Did you have a birthday the other day? I'm sure you had a birthday the other day. Yeah, I wished you a happy birthday. Thank you, Alan. Shamrock. Ashley said, did you do a shout-out for me, dear, as I was delivering? Yes, I did. I keep mentioning your name all the time, Ashley. All the time. All the time. And you can have a little chat with me again tonight, and you can tell me what other things that you'd like to do. All right, Ashley, thank you very much. Alan says he loves the shirt. Thank you very much. Yes, green shirt. I'll probably be wearing this one tonight, actually, because I've only worn it once today for the show. You know, I've got another green shirt, which actually I prefer to this one. It's a more luminous colour, but unfortunately, it won't do up around my stomach at the moment. Oh, do you know, I haven't weighed myself for a while. We're on the giving up for Lent, aren't we? Crisps, bread, cakes and chocolate and sweets. And I haven't weighed myself recently, so I need to do that. Oh, I've discovered over in the Co-op, there's a little Co-op, you know, mini supermarket type thing. So it's like a corner shop just down the road from me. And they now do little new potatoes in a tray with some sort of green herbs and a bit of butter in there. A pound! It's only a pound for all those. Oh, it's lovely. And you just shove them in the microwave for 7 or 8 minutes. Very, very tasty indeed. Mmm. And a co-op. And they're also doing these bags of vegetables, which are only £1 or £1.50, depending what you want in them. The £1.50 one, they've got sugar snap peas, little sweet corn things, broccoli and carrots in there. Or you can just have broccoli, carrots and cauliflower. They do the same size bag, is only a pound. So they're doing some new stuff in the Co-op, which is quite handy because it's only down the road from me. Usually, you know, I'll have to get in the car or on my bike and go all the way to Waitrose, because I just don't like Sainsbury's. There's something about that shop that's offensive. Sainsbury's, you offend me. I'm offended. 0208144377 is my phone number. Still time to call in this morning, boys and girls. Ashley says, I will see you later tonight. Have a catch up. Yes, yeah, I look forward to you telling me what you want to do today. I really do, my darling. All right. Thank you very much. I've got a couple of news stories, although where they've gone, I don't know. There they are. A couple of news stories for you this morning. Now, if you ever wondered, and I got to say, we were sending over... Well, I've got one here. We were sending these out a little while ago. United Kingdom Talk mugs. And if you were lucky enough to get one, we only had 20 done. And I mentioned it towards the end of one of my shows a few weeks ago. They've all gone now. But unfortunately, a couple of them got broken in the post. One got broken and I sent another one and it didn't get there. So if we do another giveaway, which will probably be around Christmas time, unless I win the lottery, in which case I will buy you all something nice. You know, probably a little framed photograph of myself for you to pin up on your wall. Now, what more could you want? You know, now is the time to start thinking about your Christmas presents, boys and girls. How about a nice framed picture of me, signed and autographed, especially for your loved ones? Now, how much do you think I should charge for something like that? Eh? Wouldn't you like that? Just imagine, you know, you could put it on your bedside cabinet, couldn't you? And, you know, on the days that you can't wake up, you know, or you can't get to sleep, you know, you just look over and there's my beaming face. There's my beaming face as you open your eyes. And I think it would create a nice feeling to look, wake up and see me when you can't get to sleep. And you could put your arms around yourself in bed and pretend that it's me. And I'm sure you would drop straight off. I'm sure you would. Anyway, with the broken cups, I'm not surprised, really. There's an article in this morning's Daily Mail. And it says, ever wondered why your suitcase goes missing? An outraged passenger has... I know the cups. Well, one of the cups has gone missing, isn't it? And another one's broken. Dear me. An outraged passenger... I am outraged! An outraged passenger has caught has caught luggage handlers hurling suitcases from a plane like rubbish bags after a flight to London's Luton Airport. And there is actually a video in this morning's Daily Mail of this. Now, I think we all know that they don't treat bags particularly carefully, but this video is something else. It really is. This bloke filmed the reckless workers unloading the bags and cases from an EasyJet flight. In the footage, two men stand at the back of the truck, which will eventually transport the cases across the runway to the airport terminal. They are seen hurling the cases, carrying precious souvenirs and gifts. And you know how it is. You know how it is, especially if it goes somewhere like the States. You know how cheap stuff is, and you want to bring people back little presents. Well, you can't put them all... Okay, you can put the clothes in the case. It's unlikely something's going to happen to those. But I'm sure, like me, you've bought little china items or glass things, and you can only put so much in that hand luggage, can't you? Even in the posh seats that I go in... Well, I don't fly anymore. I've had enough of the whole flying thing. It gets on my blooming nerves. I hate it. But when I was flying, even in the posh seats, you can only carry so much with you. And I'm sure, like me, you've put things like... I bet you've put cameras in there in your hold-all luggage, haven't you? Cameras and electric items, perhaps a laptop computer. You didn't want to carry it with you on the plane, so you put it in there. Well, don't do it. Don't do it again. They are chucking these bags. I mean chucking. They are seen hurling the cases, carrying precious souvenirs and gifts onto the back of the truck. Some of them even crash onto the runway below. It's understood the baggage handlers work for a company called Menzies Aviation, although I don't know. I'm just reading this out of the Daily Mail this morning, who have their contracts for this work at most UK airports. Luton Airport told the Mail the contract was awarded by EasyJet. He followed it up with a comment, "This sums up, well, some of the worst. Hope these idiots get kicked in the face and then fired." Yes, I hope so too. They should be fired. How can you treat people's property like that? You are being paid to do a job properly. It's disgusting. It's been viewed hundreds of thousands of times, this video, in the Daily Mail this morning, and attracted hundreds of comments from other outraged airline users. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll copy that. Now, I do have Twitter. OK, I have got Twitter as well as the Facebook. I've never got on with Twitter. I don't really get it. I know that sounds stupid. Sometimes I might see like someone's comment and then I can't work out how to find the replies to the comment and things like that. But I have got a Twitter and I do tweet little my shows on there as well. My Twitter is Chris Reardon UK. It's the same as my Facebook and the same as my YouTube. So facebook.com/ChrisReardonUK, twitter.com/ChrisReardonUK, youtube.com/ChrisReardonUK. Generally, if I've got something, it finishes with Chris Reardon UK. So I've tweeted that, okay? I've tweeted that. Can you do me a favour? If you go on my Twitter thing and you can see that, because I don't know I've done it right. I'm really useless at Twitter. Isn't it funny? Can't get on with Twitter. I've never been able to get on with it. I've tweeted it now on my Twitter. Can you click that little heart thing so that I know you can see it? Otherwise, I don't know if you can see it or not. It's a bit, I find it very complicated, Twitter. And besides, you know me, I can't say everything I want in 140 characters. That's why these shows are getting longer and longer. 140 characters, I don't think so. Oh, dear. Alan says, send me one. I'm your favourite singer. Too late, Alan. We've run out, mate. You've got to watch all the shows for these little things to come up. Otherwise, you miss out, you see. We gave away these mugs weeks ago. You're obviously not paying attention, Alan. It's no use popping in for a couple of seconds here, there and everywhere. Got to stay for the old show. Going back to the story there. Someone put a comment, idiots is putting it mildly. It's disgusting. A spokesman for Menzies Aviation says, Menzies Aviation considers the safe conveyance of passengers' luggage to be a matter of the highest importance. Well, you obviously don't. Why do they come out with that crap? No one ever apologises anymore. Have you noticed that? They defend their actions. No one ever apologises. All they do is defend their actions. Have you ever wrote a letter to complain to the BBC? They don't say, oh, well, we're sorry, but... No! They just defend their actions. No one apologises anymore. And they haven't apologised. Although they did say the behaviour displayed in this video is unacceptable and an investigation is already underway. What investigation? You got the bloody film. What, you blind as well and stupid? You got the film? Sack them. Get rid of them. Get people there who respect other people's property. We will take whatever action is necessary to ensure that such behaviour is stopped and our professional standards are upheld properly in the future. Well, they weren't that time. You're not obviously not keeping a good enough eye on your staff, are you? Eh? Years ago, of course, you know, there'd be the staff there and there'd be a supervisor as well, watching them. No, let's save money. Let's not have a supervisor. Let's save money. Idiots. An EasyJet spokesman says, we've been assured by our provider that this is being investigated. We work closely with all of our airport partners to ensure our passenger bags are handled securely. So there we are. So hopefully that will be sorted out. But it's awful. Just horrendous how people's property can be treated like that. Good morning to Ray Reynolds. Oh, you join us very late today, Ray. How come you keep joining us at the end of the show, Ray? I mean, are you trying to tell me something? You know, I'm only here for another few minutes, Ray. Do try and keep up with the rest of us, Ray. Right, I'm actually going to finish now, believe it or not, because it's time to go swimming. Just do today's birthdays, boys and girls. We've got a few birthdays. Thank you very much, those of you that called in this morning. I really appreciate that. Oh, I meant to read this Facebook message that came up this morning. People are always putting different posts and things on Facebook. A couple of things that get on my nose. Pictures of people's dinner. Oh, my dinner is here. And then you see a steak and chips or dead animal and chips on a plate, don't you? Or, you know, a bowl of vegetable soup. Like we've never seen a bowl of vegetable soup or a steak and chips before. And the other one, a lot of people do, they just cut and paste the same offer. Oh, if you are really my friend, click like and then I know that you'll be my friend or... What I want you to do is put a sentence telling us exactly how we met and then I won't unfriend you. Or if you click this immediately, you will receive £200. And I'm fed up saying, please, if you're going to do posts, can they be a bit original or interesting? The amount of rubbish. No, let's see if I can find one of the latest pieces of the rubbish that I've received. That people want me to pass on or something like that. I bet I can't find anything now, actually. I'm fortunate that I do get quite a lot of messages through there. Good morning. Morning, Mark.
Hello.
Hello. Have you moved to a better area now, Mark?
Can you guys hear me? That's the main thing.
We can hear you now, Mark. Yes, you are operating within normal perimeters.
I wanted to call in before you finish your show.
Yes.
Very quickly.
That's all right. Take your time, Mark.
Yeah, so I'm talking to you about my Irish experiences
right.
over the past few years.
Yeah.
So last year I went out as always, which I'm going to do in about 3 hours' time. I'm going out.
Where did you go last year? Can you just turn me off in the background there, Mark? I can hear that really loud.
Oh, I've got This Morning on. That's not you. That's I've got This Morning.
I beg Hang your on. Pardon. I will not be put on in the background. How dare you? Turn that telly off now. This Morning. I've heard it all now. We're not allowed to rebroadcast other people's programmes, or they get very upset about that ITV. Philip Schofield and Holly personally come round here and they would beat me. They would beat me, dear. Beat me.
Yeah, so I basically... I'm going out into my local Irish bar very soon.
Where's that, Mark?
And it's in Edgware, in Knightwell.
What's it called?
Oh, I'm moving here again.
Yeah, I'm here. No, I'm here.
Can you hear me? That's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, so last year I went out and I got very drunk and stuff like that. It's very, very, very brilliant to go out there because they do free Irish stew.
Oh, like what Mary's making today, yeah?
Yeah, so I was listening to Mary earlier and... I might have come down to Central Station tonight because I hear she's giving out free stew.
I think she's doing that this afternoon. She said she was doing that sometime this afternoon. But I don't know. Maybe you could send her a little message and check that because I wouldn't like you to come down there and it's all gone.
Oh, no, I know. But the cake sounds nice that she's making.
Oh, the cake sounds very... vodka jelly cake or something, wasn't it? Yeah.
Vodka jelly cake, yeah.
Do you like vodka jellies?
I love it. I love it. I've had them quite a lot.
I don't think I've ever seen you really drunk, to be honest.
Oh, believe me, today I am going to get probably a bit drunk.
Right.
Because I usually have about 5 pints of Guinness and I'm really drunk already. So.
You like Guinness, do you? I tried it once and it wasn't for me, but it'll be flowing tonight. You know who I remember always getting really drunk, and sadly she's no longer with us, and she was a lovely girl, a little thing she was, always taking pictures. What was her name?
Philly.
Little Philly, bless her
heart.
Oh, she was lovely. She, as I say, she's no longer with us, unfortunately. But I always remember her leaving Belushi's in London Bridge on several occasions. And I was actually worried how she would get home in that state. I really was. But she was a lovely girl. She did like a drink, didn't she? Was she Irish?
She loved it. But, going back to, you know, you said about St. Patrick's Festival.
Yes.
So... I pretty much go every year
right.
up there. But as Mary was saying earlier on, it does get very busy down there because you get all the tourists and anyone really up there.
And so, what is there to see there, Mark?
Nothing really. There's a few bands on and they have loads of craft stalls on, like loads of Irish craft stalls and activities for the kids.
Right.
And so you can bring your little ones down and... They're trying to make it as big as they can every year. This year, they make it a 3-day event.
Right. So, do they do face painting? Do they do face painting?
Yeah,
for their children. Yeah. I like seeing that.
And but, I mean, it's like St. Patrick's Day is one of the most amazing events of the year.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't have to be Irish. It's just like go out and have fun with your friends and stuff.
That's right.
But I mean, I'm going off. Like I said, I'm going off to my local very soon, and they give out free Irish shamrocks as well, which I get every year.
Well, bring one tonight with you.
Oh, I'll try. Yeah, I might have the luck of the Irish tonight.
Is that supposed to bring you good luck? Shamrock? Is it? It's not
shamrock.
Like,
yeah,
it's not one of those. What's that thing where you kiss underneath it? What's that? Oh, that's mistletoe. That's mistletoe at Christmas, isn't it? Yeah, I'm getting confused.
Yeah,
just another plant.
it's just like you know it. I hope everyone on UK Talk have a brilliant day, no matter what you're doing. It's just good. It's an office day. And as Mrs. Doyle would say from Father Ted, go on, will you not have a little cup?
Do you want to try that again?
go on, will you not have a little cup?
Go on. Oh, talking of, did you say, was it Mrs. Brown then?
Oh, Mrs. Brown? No, Mrs. Doyle.
Something I just remembered that I was going to say. Mrs. Brown, she's got her own chat show starting soon. Did you know that?
Yeah, she has, yeah. She's, it's a Saturday night, I think.
Yeah,
It's going to be the whole family of hers.
It looks quite good. I shall give that a turn. Anything's got to be better than that nightly show on ITV.
Oh, that is awful.
Oh,
is
do you know, there's now less than 1 million people watching it, which is really bad for a 10 o'clock show. Less than 1 million people watching that. I haven't seen Davina. Now, I quite like Davina McCall. Is it McCall?
McCall.
I quite like her. But according to one of the papers yesterday, she's very wooden on there. It's not like flowing like a normal conversation with people. You know, they're getting the wrong. It's no good just putting a star on there. You know, if they can't do the job, it's going to look awful. I think I should be employed to do that program. What do you reckon, Mark?
Yeah, you should. Yeah.
I can have interesting people on there like yourself.
Yeah, I mean, they've got celebrity guests on that Mrs. Brown show.
Ah, good.
So she's just going to be talking, to celebrities. Because I know Philip Schofield recorded it yesterday.
Oh, yes.
Straight after the show, him and Holly Willoughby, they went straight up to Glasgow. So,
oh, wow. Does it start this Saturday, does it?
I don't know about this Saturday. Probably either the following Saturday or the Saturday after that.
Okay.
because obviously it's this Saturday night is quite busy with things that's going on BBC, and then you've got next week you've got Comic Relief happening and stuff like that. So
here we go. I'm just about to find it now. When is it going to be on? When is it all around to it hasn't got an exact date there. It must be there somewhere. Let's see. No, I haven't got a date. They haven't given a date yet, apparently. Oh, that's a shame. Well, I can't remember Mrs. Brown. Has she got like an Irish thing? Is she supposed to be Irish, Mrs. Brown?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's Irish, the guy. I've actually met him, Brendan O'Carroll. Have you? He's a very nice guy.
You've met loads of celebrities, though, haven't you? You've met loads of them.
I have, yeah. I've met so many. It's unbelievable. I've even met a couple of Father Ted casts.
Oh, right.
And you Mrs. Doyle, I've met her. Pauline, and she's lovely as well.
Yeah. Yeah. And so who do you think is the biggest star that you've met, other than myself, of course, Mark?
Definitely. On this world-renowned international talk show that we have every single day. Like some of the people from America watching you. This is great.
Millions, dear. Millions of people all over the world.
This is why I called in today, you see. St. Patrick's Day, you never know. Hello to any Irish. I know non-Irish Mary is on here still. Well,
yeah, she was calling in earlier. Well, I hope to see you a little bit later, Mark.
I will. I'm going to go and get ready now. I'm going to go and have my my breakfast.
Yeah.
Even though it's nearly lunchtime. And then I'm going to go down and have three Irish stews.
Excellent. Don't leave it too late to come along tonight, because you know how busy it's getting in there on a Friday now. Okay.
It depends how intoxicated I am.
If you get there at 8:30, you should be able to get three in. Okay?
Okay, yeah. And I'll do some, like, Dirty Old Town and all that and...
Bring them all out, my friend. Bring them all out. Enjoy your day, Mark. All right, thanks for calling in.
On next week, and I'll tell you all about my experience tonight.
Please do. You can give a proper evaluation of our night. Well, you probably do it. Ring in tomorrow if you want, or you won't be up early tomorrow.
Unfortunately, my internet decided to go down on me, so I'm calling you by my mobile.
Are you working at the Arsenal tomorrow?
No, I've got a day off.
You're off. That's what I was asking you. What do you actually do there? Are you steward?
I do customer service.
Right. So, for example, what? I buy the tickets from you, or?
No,
if I've got a complaint?
I take people to their seats and take them to medical areas.
Right. Okay. So almost like a steward, assisting people. Yeah.
That's exactly my job title.
And you enjoy that, don't you? Do you get to see all the matches? Do you get to see the matches for nothing then?
Yes.
Excellent. Excellent. Because my nephew, he's a Chelsea supporter and he's 19. And I just can't believe it when he tells me how much these bloody tickets are. And a lot of the time he has to buy them second hand because people buy them all up and resell them. Don't they?
Yeah.
Yeah. So the other day, I think it was it last Saturday? Was Chelsea playing last Saturday? Oh, no, yeah. it was Luton, because Lincoln, wasn't it? It was Lincoln. And, of course, he's from up there, so he supports them as well. And loads of them come down on coaches and in trains and all that business. But to get to get the ticket, he had to buy, I don't know how it works, he had to buy it off the internet from some bloke in London.
Yeah.
And he had to send Gary's his brother, his best mate is Paul. He had to send his mate Paul over to Wimbledon to collect the ticket. So it's all, and it costs a lot of money. So I know how much they cost. So that's well worth having, isn't it, Mark?
Yeah.
Doing that sort of stuff. Right, well, I'll see you later on tonight then.
Yeah, I better let you finish your show, because now you've gone right over the time.
Oh, it doesn't matter, but it gets to the point where you're thinking, hang on a minute, I need to go now, otherwise I won't be able to do everything else I usually do during the daytime.
Yeah. Well, I'm gonna get back to watching this morning, because it's an Irish special today, and one of my friend's band is playing.
All right. Have a nice day, Mark, and I'll see you tonight, all right?
So.
Cheerio now.
I'll see you soon, Chris.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. There we are, Mark calling in there. That was an excellent call, wasn't it? That actually worked that time. All right. good morning to Duke, who's with us. Morning, Duke. You never turned up for my quiz, Duke. I was hurt and offended. You were supposed to be turned up for my quiz on Wednesday. Morning, Duke. I don't know if you're coming along tonight, are you? To the St. Patrick's Night at Central Station. Kevin's with us this morning. Good morning, Kevin. Sorry, Kevin. I didn't reply to your message yesterday, did I? Good morning, Kevin. I think that's it, is it? Yep, that's it this morning. Let's do today's birthdays. Oh, that was a thing. I saw something on Facebook this morning, and this kind of goes along the cut and paste thing that people do and all that. But this kind of makes sense. This is for couples who flaunt their love on Facebook, then suddenly go quiet after they break up. You need to tell us exactly what happened. We invested a lot of time, likes and comments on your pictures. We need closure as well. So that's a good one, isn't it? You know when people suddenly meet someone and it's all over there. Oh, I've met the love of my life, and with all these pictures of kissing and tongues and slogging and all that's going on. And then suddenly it all stops. So we do want the gory details, please, when you split up as well. If you don't mind. Thank you very much. Right, today's birthdays then. Here come today's birthdays. If it's your birthday today, I'm about to sing to you. Happy birthday today to Barry Manilow fan Helen Litman, who's... do I read your age? No, I won't read your age out, Helen. Not, I don't suppose it bothers you anyway, but I'll leave that for you. Helen Litman is her birthday today, one of our Barry Manilow girls. Happy birthday, Helen. Happy birthday to Juan David Respicio Salenda. I hope I said that all right. Happy birthday to you, sir. Happy birthday to all-round good guy, a gentleman that I used to work with in Belushi's in Hammersmith. And he's such a nice bloke. He was in a band playing, I think, lead guitar, if I remember rightly. Mark Hudson, 29. 29, Mark. The big 3-0 for you next year, isn't it? Happy birthday, Mark. I never forget the people I work with in any of the Belushi's. I had such a wonderful time. I actually worked in 4 Belushi's. Hammersmith first, then London Bridge, also Camden and Fulham. But Hammersmith and London Bridge were very dear to me those times I had in there. Wonderful one. It was bloody hard work in there, but I had some wonderful, wonderful times in the Belushi's. And I don't forget the people I worked with. Mark and I and Vicky. There was an Australian bloke, an unusual name, and he was always drunk after he finished work. There was such a nice crowd and a real comradeship working. Indeed, Vicky called us the dream team at one point, and we all had our photo taken together. So happy birthday to you, Mark, 29 today. George Summers, no longer with us, but we still recognise people's birthdays, even though they're no longer with us. He used to go out with a lad called Mark before he died in a fire. So George Summers would have been today 46 years old. Just imagine dying in a fire. Oh, horrendous. Happy birthday today to Tone Gray, to Sam Lowe, to Stephen Labadie, 24 today, very young, half my age, less than half my age. Happy birthday, Stephen. To Victoria Oliveira, 31 today. Love that photo, holding the phone there. Happy birthday, Victor. So did I say Victoria? No, incorrect. Victor. To Victor Oliveira. I hope I said that right. 31 today. Love that. That's a nice suit you got on there. That don't look like a Topshop job. It looks like a posh suit. And to Martin Hill, who is today 59 years old. Here comes the song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. All right. Whatever you're doing today, boys and girls, have a really nice time on your birthdays, okay? Perhaps you'll come down if you're in London. I'll be hosting karaoke tonight and indeed every Friday night. That's at Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. Everyone's welcome. It's free to get in. Starts at 8:30. I would get there at 8 o'clock if you want a chair tonight. Honestly, I really would. There's only so many tables and chairs. There's quite a lot of them. But it's getting to the point now where you've got to get a little bit early if you actually want to see it, all right? So that's tonight, Central Station Bar, Wharfdale Road, King's Cross, London, every Friday, 8:30 till 12 midnight. Apart from that, enjoy your Friday, and I'll see you again very soon. Thanks for watching and listening. Cheerio now.